Hello there guys and welcome back to the channel. In today's video we're going to be taking a look at some options how to defeat this rogue in variant 3 chapter 3 quest 1. So she has like a super annoying regeneration plus mighty charge and rogue's ability to shrug up debuffs quickly combined with mighty charge that regen. It just is a fairly difficult fight and you need to have like a specific answer for her. And honestly, the kind of easiest, most simple, straightforward answer is simply taking Mephisto. So initially I did not know whether I'm going to be able to damage her only while I have my soul imprisonment active or not. Therefore I chose to spam my level 1 attacks and that kind of prevented her from regeneration. However, even when I ran out of soul imprisonment and my soul charges, she did not gain her regeneration buff back. Therefore, you can take in any Mephisto of pretty much any rarity. Obviously, the lower rank Mephisto you have, the longer the fight is going to be and your damage is halved. So be ready for a long fight. However, if you do not have any kind of like of the standard answers to this rogue, and you have a Mephisto that's decently ranked up, he will work wonders against this rogue. It will be a long fight, but it will be a simple fight, just because you don't have to worry about anything. It's just a regular fight. You don't have to kind of worry about keeping your combo. You don't have to worry about doing certain things in certain time or baiting out her special attacks in time or anything like that. Just a plain old simple fight. Mephisto will take her down and it won't be hard. It will simply take quite a bit of time, but on the bright side, it won't matter if you mess up. You're not gonna have to start it all over. You can simply revive your Mephisto and just keep going at it, chipping away at her. And yeah, so Mephisto is a fantastic option if you're unable to out damage her in basically any other kind of way. So obviously, once again, I'm not going to show the entire fight. I didn't even do the entire fight just because I had some other fights to record and I didn't want to waste too much time. And here we're going to drop a level 3 and then I'm just going to cut the recording. So here we go, just because we wanted to eat that rogue. But yeah, we're going to move on to the second option just after Mephisto's level 3. I did want to kind of show a bit longer clip of this fight just to show that the regeneration buff does not come back, in fact. And now we are dropping Mephisto's L3 and that will be it for this clip. And there we go, just let this animation finish off. And next fight is Human Torch. Now I'm not going to show the entire clip, I'm going to show like the second part of the fight, because initially I started with suicides. I had suicides at the time I was recording this and I had to wait out my bleed and stuff like that. But anyways, point is, you do use your pre-fight ability and then your Nova Flames can reverse rogue's regeneration, and because they are passive, they cannot be shrugged off by mighty charge. So ideally you do pretty much 3 hit combos, medium, light, medium, to keep on as many no flames as you can, and that should take care for that regeneration for most part. A quick tip to make your life easier before you drop your level 3, and that is the special I think you should be using, you want to charge your heavy attack to get your temperature up as high as possible before releasing your level 3, so that will kind of increase the duration of your incinerates and that will help you do kind of more healer reversal. Now it isn't like a super simple fight, but still it is one of the easier options, and also it won't matter realistically how strong your Human Torch is for most part, because here you are in fact reversing the heal for most part instead of actually trying to deal enough damage. So damage here is halved as is, but once again the most important bit here is your ability to reverse her heal, not being able to out damage it. Therefore even a low ranked Human Torch would be able to do this fight, provided you fight carefully and don't take too much cheap damage. But as you can see here, she's about to drop. We're just gonna finish off the combo and we're gonna kill her off with our level 3, just because. So yeah, Human Torch also a fantastic option because of his Nova Flames. Nova Flames are passive. Passive debuffs don't get shrugged off by mighty charge and they still work just perfectly fine. Only problem you have is the half damage output from Global Node in this variant. And then next clip is simple Star-Lord. Even a 4-star Star-Lord would work in this one as well, because you ramp up your damage kind of indefinitely. Now the one thing with Star-Lord though is obviously you have to fight well. If you do mess up, you have to start all over. If you die before finishing off the rogue, it basically, yeah, You are back to square one. And this video I am running Suicide still as well on my Star-Lord, therefore I'm not really going to be spamming special attacks, but ideally I would probably suggest sticking to your level ones for initial part of the fight and kind of safely baiting out her special attacks. One thing you will notice in this video about Mighty Charge is that even if she will dash at you and you are striking her, her first hit will not break your combo. So we're gonna see it in a second here. So we are hitting her block as well, just to give her a bit more power. We're not worried about her regeneration initially, because I know I can't outdamage it from get-go. Therefore, I don't kind of try to rush too much. I don't mind tapping her block a couple of times, just to give her a bit more power, just to give her that special, so I can bait it out and get a free opening. So whenever I get a chance, I hit a rogue's block multiple times, just to push her deeper into her power bar. And then I try to punish her special attacks for most part. So that is fairly kind of easy strategy to deal with, relatively safe, will help you avoid taking too much cheap damage trying to like block bait heavy attacks. As we saw there, even if she's dashing at you, if you're striking her at that precise moment, it does not break your combo. So that is one thing you need to know when dealing with Mighty Charge. So it kind of helps you a lot to kind of keep your fight going, because that hit does in fact land. It adds to your combo meter and also gives Rogue more power, which is exactly what you want, because you are baiting her special attacks out. Now here we are 81 hits in, and soon we are going to reach the point where we're actually going to be able to outdamage that regeneration, and then we're going to be able to go more and more aggressive. That is also the point where I'm going to drop off my level 3 attack and going to start shooting my specials. But yeah, as we can see here, she's back at 100%. So when you actually do start damaging her, you do want to stay aggressive. You do not want to let her heal off too much. Sometimes you have issues baiting out her special attacks, which can be annoying, but keep in mind that your damage output is constantly increasing. And even if she does regenerate back a substantial chunk of health, every subsequent time you're going to be taking it off, it's going to be easier and easier, just because you hit harder the longer you are in the fight. So at this point we can see that some of the crits are dealing some really good damage. She's down to 80%, healing back slowly. Think somewhere soon here I'm going to be dropping my level 3 attack, when I will not be able to push her bar of power like immediately. So she's at 80%, 77, and we dropped below 50 ourselves, so that will give us some courage damage, which isn't a lot, but still any bit helps when you are trying to outdamage somebody's regeneration. So Star-Lord here, we are struggling a bit, I suppose, but we are 139 hits in. We're doing some decent amount of damage. So finally, I do drop my level 3, and this is like when we're going for the kill. So this level 3 already should do a decent chunk of damage. And quick note to add, my Star-Lord is Sig 200, so realistically, if your Star-Lord isn't as high Sig, you probably will take a bit longer to drop her, but it kind of idea remains the same. Even a 4-star Star-Lord could fairly easily be able to outdamage this rogue, just you would have to get to a higher combo in comparison. So we dropped a level 1, she's at 6%, and we do need to bait that special attack out thing, but she doesn't want to throw it, and then I get frustrated, so I drop a combo on her. She's at 2%, finally drops her special attack, one crit, 19k, and rogue goes down. So it's a fairly easy solo with Star-Lord, nothing too much to worry about. And now we're going to take a look at the final kind of bit from my fight with She-Hulk. So I did post a separate video about She-Hulk if you want to see the entire fight there, but the base idea is we just build up Furies and drop our level 3, and then drop a couple of level 2 attacks to temporarily reverse the regen for a bit. That does help some as well, plus the damage from level 2. And also, Rogue doesn't really dash against She-Hulk for most part, just because she will be continuously throwing her special attacks without dashing forward. Therefore, the debuff we place on level 2 does not get shrugged off, it gets its full duration, so we reverse the heal there. So she is at like 42% there. We need to get to another level 2, shoot that off. I was running low on health there, so we're gonna have to finish her off just with our regular damage output. But She-Hulk functions extremely similarly as Star-Lord in this kind of case, because she does build up her damage over time, and eventually, even without level 2s, we would have been able to outdamage that regeneration, even with our attack kind of cut in half, because She-Hulk isn't tech champion. But yeah, so She-Hulk is a really good option. And fight-wise, fight is easier with She-Hulk than it is with Star-Lord. It will take longer though, so there is that. Another option is if you are lucky enough to have a highly ranked Mysterio, Mysterio's heal block works against Rogue because he has a passive heal block. So obviously my 4-star, it's like 4-star 220. I'm not going to be even trying to do any serious damage Rogue in this fight. We're just kind of demonstrating that the idea you want to do is you want to get 3 of your charges to make sure your heal block lasts as long as you possibly can make it last. And then we can see that even though she's dashing forward and Mighty Charge is activating, that heal block is still in place. It does not get shrugged off. In order to out damage Rogue though, you will need fairly highly ranked Mysterio in this fight. And yeah, you will need to be aggressive and you will want to make sure she's throwing her special attacks fairly frequently, because you can have up to 100% uptime on that heal block, but you need to have like fast, good paced fight in order to do that. But still, as you can see here, even rank 2, 4-star, we are slowly but surely taking away that Rogue bit by bit. So here she is at like 99%, so we didn't manage to do 1% damage, 98%, 2% damage. So yeah, Mysterio is putting in work, right? Couple percent at a time still counts. Yeah, but definitely don't try it with a low ranked Mysterio. It's going to be a really hard and difficult fight. However, if you have highly ranked Mysterio, if you got lucky, got him as 6-star from Cavaliers or grinded for a 5-star, it will work out well for you. Obviously, the last clip is going to be from Sentinel. Now, my Sentinel is rank 5, and a Sentinel can simply out damage this node as well. I'm not running any suicides, any special mastery setups, so my Sentinel is maxed out. So I saw, I believe, Seton take him down with a 6-star rank 1 and like a mutant crit team. And you can definitely do it with like a rank 4 Sentinel as well. You simply might need some boosts or some tech power boosts or something of the sort, or some added crit damage to Sentinel, because we're going to see that my Sentinel is rank 5 and she isn't going down all that slowly. We do need to kind of be super aggressive and it's still going to take a while. Now, obviously, I'm not including Ghost in these clips because I think Ghost is everybody's obvious choice to simply out damage this Rogue, and that was kind of the point of the video, to how to take her down if you do not have a Ghost. But yeah guys, I hope this one is helpful. If you have any ideas how to take this Rogue down with any other champions, I have heard that like super boosted maxed out stack Spider-Man can do it on like suicides, and probably there are some other options, so I would definitely be interested to know on which ones I am blanking out on. Also, please do let me know which other fights in variant you guys find difficult and tricky, and I will do my best to kind of record similar videos to this one to kind of explain the fight, to show some options, to kind of tell you what you should be looking for, what you should be going for. But yeah, also do let me know how you are enjoying this variant. Do you like it? Where do you rank it compared to the first two? What are your thoughts and general opinions on it? I will kind of post a separate video kind of overall going over the entire variant as soon as I have 100% explored it, and then I'll give like my general thoughts about it. So far I like it. So far it doesn't seem overly difficult or tricky, and I'm definitely a fan. But yeah, anyhow, so this will be me more or less done for today's video. Will be enough of me rambling here. We can see that Sentinel is taking her down slowly but surely. So if you are new to the channel, hit that like button, hit that sub button, hit that bell icon to stay notified, share it to your friends. Perhaps your friends can benefit from contents on this channel as well. I will be most grateful if you do. And that will be me more or less done for today's video. We will be streaming variant live as I'm exploring it. For initial exploration, I will be doing it with my like Ghost and Sentinel and all the kind of heavy hitters. Later on, we will also be doing rank 3, 5-star and 4-star only exploration. So definitely stay tuned for that. And yeah, that's pretty much it. See you.